بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
Let's take a look at the history of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we'll concentrate on the history of Rasulullah in Medina, because that's when the society, the Islamic society, was established. In Medina, when the Prophet arrived sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there were Jews, there were non-Muslims. So what the Prophet did is he sat down and they drafted a treaty between them. In fact, there is a writer by the name of Watt. He writes in a book called Muhammad at Medina. He says there were several articles between the Muslims and the Jews. Article number 25, he quotes, "The Jews of Bani Auf are a community." This is now in the treaty between the Prophet and the Jews of Medina. "The Jews of Bani Auf are a community," between brackets, Ummah, "along with the believers. To the Jews, their religion," in bracket, "deen," "and to the Muslims, their religion." This is article 25. Article 37, this one is interesting. Listen, again he quotes it. "It is for the Jews to bear their expenses and for the Muslims to bear their expenses. Between them, that is to one another, there is help, nasr, against whoever wages wars against the people of this document." In other words, if anyone wages wars against the Muslims or the Jews, they will help one another. There is help, nasr, between them, the Jews and the Muslims. Between them is sincere friendship and honorable dealing, not treachery. This is in the treaty, and this is by Watt in his book, Muhammad in Medina. So that's when it comes to the Jews. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam honored them. He did not force Islam upon them, wrote a treaty with them. Then people say, and they question, well then, what happened? Well, the Jews were with the Muslims. Indeed, in fact, in the Battle of Uhud, when the Battle of Uhud took place, they sat down, the Prophet sat down and discussed with the Jews and the Muslims in Medina. He said, "What shall we do? Quraysh is attacking us." The Jews said, "Nobody has attacked us in our city and won against us. So let us stay in Medina and fight against them in Medina, inside Medina. Let's teach them a lesson." Some of the young Muslims, youthful ones, they were energetic. They said, "No, Ya Rasulullah, if they're coming to attack us, we're going to teach them a lesson before they even reach Medina. So let's go outside and fight them outside." And then the majority prevailed. Majority, they said, "Yeah, let's go fight them outside." And hence the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam agreed and took their suggestion. Again, here to show that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was tolerant. He sat down, discussed with all people. He is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He received the revelation from Allah. He can choose. He can tell people, "This is what we'll do." He sat down discussing with them. When it comes to political matters, they take their opinion, other people's opinion. When it comes to religious matters, however, it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to assigning the Khalifa, that's from Allah. That does not take Shura. You don't have consensus there or political decision. That's from Allah. Nonetheless, and then the Jews said, "No, since you're going to go outside, we're not going to support you. We will support you if you stay inside." But nonetheless, there was cooperation. They discussed. But what happened is they went against the treaty. When? In the Battle of Al-Khandaq. In the Battle of Al-Ahzab, there was cooperation behind the backs of the Muslims with the non-believers. And hence, that's when they went against the terms of the treaty. Rasulullah said, "Now you'll have to leave Medina." And they left Medina. Same thing happened with the Jews of Khaybar. However, the Jews of Fadak, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, "Ya Rasulullah, we will not believe in your faith, but we will pay the tax. We will live under the protection of the Islamic State, and we will pay you the tax." Now some people say, "Well, why the tax? This is not fair." Tell them, hold on a second. If people, immigrants, come to a foreign country and they work here in this country, don't they have to pay tax? They're obliged to pay tax. Why? Because this country offers them services. Their children go to school, they get medical insurance, and so on and so forth. In return for this, they have to pay taxes. Similarly, in Islam, in a truly Islamic state, the Islamic state provides education. The Islamic state provides medication and health. The Islamic state provides protection, and hence, that requires tax. And same thing with the Muslims. They have to pay zakat, they have to pay khums, they have to pay hukuk, and so on and so forth. So they have to pay tax. Same thing happened not only with the Jews, with the Christians, Nasara Najran, the Christians of Najran, those who came to discuss with the Prophet, they also said, "Ya Rasulullah, we will not pay you. We will not believe in your faith, but we'll pay you the jizya. will live under your faith. I mean, will live under your state, the Islamic state. And indeed, Rasulullah left them alone, practicing their religion and freedom. Did not interfere with them at all. In fact, the Prophet wasallam sent the Muslims to Habasha, to Najashi. He sheltered the Muslims beforehand until they came back to Medina. So we find that Rasulullah tolerated that state. And even when Islam grew bigger and non-Muslims other than Christians and Jews became under the state of or the umbrella of Islam, they also were not forced to become Muslims. No compulsion. There was no compulsion. Read the history. That's the time of Rasulullah.
Ya Hussein.